Welcome back. Now, as our state of Tamil Nadu reels under the confusion about which syllabus needs to be implemented in schools these days, one school in the city is determined to seek an answer to the larger debate on the format of the education system. In fact, what they have done is a unique method by itself, with pictures doing the talking. Krishnamurthy brings you this tried and tested success story. Until last year, Dhanavel was a backbencher and one of the last ranked in class 9. This year, he is the class topper. Magic? No. A simple matter of guidance and the chapter and verse for such a transformation has been scripted by CCCL as part of its corporate social responsibility.
Basically, if you see, all this technology-enabled learning helps a student in terms of the retention capability in memory. So that if you do it in the long term, they are able to relate to the subject which they have been taught at school. So when they get into the examination hall, they're able to write remembering what the teacher has taught. Whereas if you see a textbook, they might not even remember the page number. They might even lose focus of the answer.
Dhanavel says students like him understood their syllabus better and did not have to mug up lessons.
சின்ன முன்னாடி கிளாஸ்லலாம் வந்து நாங்க சப்ஜெக்ட்லாம் ரொம்ப டஃப்பா இருந்தது எங்களுக்கு டெக்ஸ்ட்புக்க பார்த்து படிக்கிறதுக்கு. இப்போ இந்த புரோகிராம் மூலம் லேப்டாப்ல வந்து பிக்சர்ஸ் விஷுவல்லாம் போட்டு காட்டவே ரொம்ப ஈஸியா இருந்தது. அந்த சப்ஜெக்ட் எல்லாம் இது பண்ணிக்கிறதுக்கு புரிஞ்சுக்க முடிஞ்சது. அதனால நான் இப்போ எல்லா சப்ஜெக்ட்லயும் நல்லா ஸ்கோர் பண்ணி ஸ்கூல் டாப்பரா வந்திருக்கேன்.
The organizers would like to see many more Dhanavels in classrooms.
It is very easy to implement this kind of activity in self-aided schools. But you know, to implement in this you know, kind of thing in government-aided school or a government school is a little bit difficult. If some of the corporates come to you know, come in front to do like this activity, it would be a greater chance. And you know, cost factor, it would cost around 750 rupees to 1500 rupees to do this activity per year for a student.
Dhanavel's success is a case in point, which proves that learning through visual aids helps students to understand and retain lessons in a better way. But will the government be willing to invest and impart education through visual aids and revamp the education system in India? In Chennai, this is Krishnamurthy for NDTV Hindu.
Now, the recent Pride March once again turns the focus on the angst among the transgender community, especially when it comes to sex reassignment surgeries, a process by which a person can finally become a complete male or female. But this is one surgery where patients are eager to go under the scalpel, but the support system is still taking baby steps. 3 years ago, Dr. Jayaraman performed the first sex reassignment surgery at the government hospital in Chennai. And till date, he has performed over 40 such surgeries.
So in that process, we should get the legal opinion and also their physical fitness regarding the surgery. All these things we obtain and then we go ahead with the surgery.
The deep urge to transform from male to female comes with a huge price tag, costing anywhere between 1.5 lakhs and 5 lakh rupees in private hospitals. It is done free of cost in government hospitals, but there is a long queue.
It's left up to an individual to decide whether to focus on anatomy or focus on quality of life. But a person has to think a lot before taking a decision. On sex reconstruction surgery or emasculation to become a third gender.
The option of a surgery itself is a huge relief to many. In the past, surgeries done by Thayamma were crude and painful.
Thayamma operation pannaanga. அதாவது திருநங்கைகளை வந்து உயிரோடு நிற்க வச்சு சுய நினைவோட அந்த ஆணுறுப்பை வந்து துண்டிக்கிற ஆப்ரேஷன். ஆணுறுப்பையும் அந்த விதைப்பையும் கட் பண்ணி தூக்கி போடுறது. சுய நினைவாக எந்த ஒரு மயக்க மருந்து எந்த ஒரு ட்ரீட்மெண்ட் கிடையாது. அறுத்து அப்படியே படுக்க வச்சு கொஞ்சம் கொதிக்க கொதிக்க எண்ணெய் ஊற்றுவாங்க அந்த ரணத்தில். இந்த மாதிரி தான் இருக்கும் அந்த ஆப்ரேஷன். ஆனால் அந்த நேரத்தில் வந்து சிலர் பிழைப்பாங்க, சிலர் செத்து போயிடுவாங்க.
But the biggest change the transgender wants is a change in people's mindset towards the community and the authorities to make sex reassignment surgeries both accessible and affordable. In Chennai with Deepika, Evelyn Matthew for NDTV Hindu. Let's move on to some national news. Now, Maria Susei Raj, the Kannada starlet who made it to the headlines for her involvement in the gruesome murder of her boyfriend Neeraj Grover, walked free from jail today, a little after noon. Following a visit to the Mahim church today, Maria, along with her lawyer, addressed a press conference this evening to give her version of what had happened. Mr. Sharif clarified that Neeraj's body was not hacked into 300 pieces like the police claimed, but into 4 to 5, and added that Maria was shocked by the conviction. While Maria, on her part, claimed that she was innocent and stayed away from speaking about the case. She did say that at the jail during the stay for 3 years, it was a time that had drawn her closer to God. The conference called by Maria saw very dramatic moments when Neeraj Grover's friends had disrupted the meeting, raising slogans asking her to speak instead of her lawyer. Meanwhile, earlier on today, Maria was escorted out of the Baikula jail in Mumbai by her brother amid the media frenzy. They managed to duck the waiting reporters and cameras and got into a car and sped away with media men following them. Maria has been in jail since 2008, and having served her time, she was let out. It was, in fact, her confession that proved to be rather crucial in determining the outcome of the case. In her confession, she stated that Neeraj was killed by Jerome in front of her. Co-accused Jerome Matthews was sentenced to 10 years of jail for murder, out of which he has already served 3 years. He was charged for culpable homicide, not amounting to murder. Meanwhile, it's not been even 24 hours since her release, but she is on the threshold of limelight. She had not yet received all of that in the years of struggle in Bangalore and Mumbai. 30-year-old Maria Surya Sesaraj is already the inspiration for Ram Gopal Varma-produced Not a Love Story. There are also reports that the Kannada actress could now get multiple offers to star in television reality shows. Filmmaker Ram Gopal Varma's comment on Twitter that he would like to sign Maria for a film that has caused an enormous controversy, with Shyam Benegal slamming the filmmaker for his desire to sensationalize the case.
All these allegations, whatever they were saying about Ramu is insensitive and he's trying to cash on to publicity on this. Yes, I am after publicity, because as a filmmaker, film making is only publicity. We only make films for publicity. There's a poster, a hoarding, a interview, a film and release karte hain, and it's a part of it. I don't look down upon the word publicity. Yeah, bas ye points, whatever is going on, the controversial thing, I just wanted to clear that. I would like to cast her when I get a script and a role, I think it will suit her, because I saw her on film now.
I don't like that, because I think the whole thing, you know, is terrible. That if anybody can stoop so low, simply because you want to cash in on it, because of the sensational value of it, and because people want to, you know, it's like there's a lot of things that people do, and later on they may hate themselves for doing it, but the fact is that people do a lot of things that they, in their right mind, wouldn't.
In some more national news, ahead of the all-party meeting on the Lokpal Bill, Team Anna met Congress President Sonia Gandhi today. Emerging from that meeting, Anna Hazare said that talks had been productive and several areas of differences on the Lokpal Bill were conveyed to Ms. Gandhi. He also said that the right draft of the Lokpal Bill should be sent to the Cabinet.
तो पार्लियामेंट में सही ड्राफ्ट जाना चाहिए
बिल्कुल
तो पार्लियामेंट में चर्चा होगी
आप चाहते हैं दोनों
ड्राफ्ट ही अधूरा भेज रहे तो चर्चा क्या होगी
आप चाहते
हैं अभी जो वो ड्राफ्ट सही भेजने के लिए हम जो गवर्नमेंट को बताया कि अगर ये सही ड्राफ्ट नहीं जाता तो 16 तारीख को जंतर मंतर पर अनशन होगा
सोनिया जी भी बता दिया आपने
सोनिया जी बताया कि वो ड्राफ्ट सही जाना चाहिए पार्लियामेंट में जाने के बाद फिर हमारा कोई प्रेशर नहीं हम उसे कोई नहीं कहेंगे कि लोकशाही का हम स्वीकार किया है पार्लियामेंट के अपोजिट में कैसे जा सकते
हैं
पार्लियामेंट जो राय लेगी उसी के मुताबिक होगा वो हम मान लिया है
सोनिया गांधी
ने कह दिया है कि
When we come back on headlines now, right away into your thoughts with A.R. Rahman playing DJ.